A day after parts of Beirut turned into a war zone due to heavy fighting that claimed six lives and wounded dozens of citizens, the army has now deployed tanks and security personnel. The fighting broke out after indiscriminate sniper fire sent protesters scurrying for cover at a rally against a judge who was tasked to investigate last year's massive port explosion. Lebanese President Michel Aoun has pledged to catch those who were involved in the deadly armed clashes and hold them accountable.
أسهر على أنه يوصل التحقيق لحقيقة ما حصل ومحاسبة المسؤولين عنه والمحرضين عليه مثله مثل أي تحقيق قضائي آخر بما فيه التحقيق بجريمة المرفأ يلي كان ورح يبقى من أولويات عملي والتزامي تجاه اللبنانيين والمجتمع الدولي.
The protest was organized by Hezbollah supporters against Judge Tariq Bitar, who is currently investigating the explosion that ripped through Beirut's port last year. On Tuesday, the judge suspended the probe for the second time in the face of lawsuits filed by former ministers he summoned on suspicion of negligence. Human rights groups condemn this as an attempt by politicians to evade justice. There have been growing calls from top officials, including the Hezbollah chief, for the judge investigating the case to be replaced. Meanwhile, the Lebanese army has said that it has arrested nine people who are suspected to be involved in the armed clashes. Now, the unrest unfolded when snipers positioned at rooftops started firing at residential buildings, purportedly in a bid to target Hezbollah and Amal supporters, who then retaliated with assault fire, volleys and rocket-propelled grenades. The bullets were seen leaving craters in the walls and windows of residential apartments.
ونحن كنا عشوائي رحنا بالمكتب صارت أوسوا علينا أنصايب. تنتف المكتب جوا ورصاص مرق من حدة شظينا ما عرفنا كيف هربنا بعد ساعتين ثلاثة هلا جينا لقينا رزقنا كله لل
The gunfire, which lasted for 5 hours, sparked memories of the 1975 to 1990 civil war, further marking the deadliest civil violence in Beirut since 2008.
هذا المشهد رجعنا لل 75، كان عمري 10 11 سنة. هيدا هو ذاته تكرر عاد ابدا فيديو سوى بمخيلتي انا وصغير هلا عاد.
Meanwhile, Lebanon's Prime Minister Najib Mikati said that the violence was a setback, but one that would be overcome. He added that his cabinet was working to provide the International Monetary Fund with the necessary financial figures ahead of talks to pull the country out of its economic meltdown.
مما لا شك فيه انها نكسه حصد. يعني لا لا يجوز المكابره ولكن حتما رغبتنا ان نتجاوزها لانه الهدف بالنتيجة اللي حنوصلها بالتعاون مع الجميع وأنا أكيد وعلى يقين أن كل اللبنانيين بدهم يوصلوا للنتيجة الإيجابية اللي عم نحكي عنها.
Now tensions over the port blast inquiry have further threatened to push Lebanon into yet another political crisis, which comes in the backdrop of a currency collapse, soaring poverty and an energy crisis that has led to extended electricity blackouts. Our correspondent Gadi Francis gets you more details in this next report from Beirut.
I'm standing here in a somehow calm Beirut today after clashes broke out yesterday. The clashes started after mysterious snipers aimed at peaceful pro-Hezbollah protesters that took to the streets to demand the removal of Judge Tariq Bitar, the lead judge investigating last year's disastrous Beirut port blast. Now the shots have left tens of injuries and the death toll has risen to seven. The Lebanese army had stepped up and took control of the streets, raiding the buildings one by one. Later on, reports announced that the Lebanese army identified some of the perpetrators and snipers and actually arrested eight. As for the standoff regarding the Judge Tariq Bitar, it is still brewing politically as Hezbollah and allies stress their demand for the removal of the judge, threatening to resign from the government and dismantle the cabinet if the Minister of the Justice and President Michel Aoun don't comply. I'm reporting from Beirut. I'm Ghadi Francis, and you're watching WION. World is One.
WION World is One is now available in your country. Download the app now and get all the news updates on the move.